Hi everyone, Markaboy with you again, out in the woods, off-grid. Today, I'd like to chat a little about solar panels and batteries. Many of you preppers, off-gridders, and survivalists may be considering a solar power installation. In this video, I'm going to give you a brief tour of my system, such as it is, and offer a few thoughts based on my experience over the years. As always, your own needs and your mileage will vary. This is about what I have done to solve my own electrical needs. Enjoy the tour. Behind me, you can see my solar panel array. My panels are a motley assemblage of salvaged, donated, and yes, even purchased equipment. Not like the beautiful, orderly, and rather expensive examples you're likely to see as you research your own installation. I'm not actually sure, but in the height of summer on a sunny day, they may deliver a 10 amp charge. All I know is this, that this is enough to meet my needs. Years ago, before YouTube was invented, when I started to formulate ideas on what shape my system would take, I often saw elaborate plans well beyond what I was able to afford. I decided to keep my needs and wants modest in order to keep things simple and avoid unnecessary monitoring and maintenance. Just like the panels you see here, my storage batteries are not perfect either, and we'll take a look at them soon. Also, what I discovered was that at the heart of even the most expensive and sophisticated systems, there was always a sturdy generator to handle large loads and or cloudy days. The panels are hooked up in parallel, and the electricity generated is conducted along a number 6 gauge wire down the outside wall underneath the cabin to the charge controller. Originally, I had a very basic, sealed, made in America charge controller. This worked just fine until the number of panels started to exceed its amperage rating. I acquired one of the panels through points on my credit card. And along with it came this controller, good for 30 amps. The price was right, but eventually this second controller went squirrely and ultimately died. Don't pay good money for a controller if it looks like this. My third generation charge controller employs what I understand to be sophisticated electrical technology called maximum power point tracking, or MPPT for short. It's a microprocessor-based system designed to maximize the power generated by the panels. And that's all I know. With this new charge controller, that's about as sophisticated as things get around here. I have no other bells and whistles to monitor and drive me crazy. Guys with too many dials and levers tend to obsess over minutiae, and I fear I would be no exception. I do employ a voltmeter for troubleshooting purposes whenever it becomes necessary, and occasionally it is indispensable, but that's about as far as I go with extra equipment. Now for the batteries. Talking about my proposed system, I was lucky enough to be offered these rather large 2-volt cells by a friendly neighbor who had access to surplus telephone company equipment. Originally, these batteries were used as a backup in a remote station, and they were retired after 10 years of light service, never seeing heavy use. That was 10 years ago, and they've served well for my purposes ever since. My purpose, your purpose, is important. We're not interested in generating power to run washers, dryers, and electric cook stoves. Neither am I interested in running power tools with these batteries through a heavy-duty inverter. One of the reasons we enjoy life here is to escape the high-voltage city lifestyle and ramp down our energy needs. This modest system is entirely sufficient for powering lighting, computers, charging phones, and other devices, and running a sound system. We use propane for cooking and refrigeration, and burn wood to keep us cozy in winter. Anyway, back to the batteries. There are 12 of them in operation, wired in 2 banks of 6 to deliver 12 volts with, in theory at least, approximately 900 amp hours of capacity. Almost any type of lead-acid batteries will perform just as well given the light use I just described. Golf cart batteries are a popular choice for solar systems as they are deep cycle, reasonably priced, and readily available.
As long as lead-acid batteries are delivered a constant charge, they will provide years of service. One of the mistakes I made early on was to leave these batteries stored without charging for a couple of years, which caused sulfation of the lead plates, reducing the battery efficiency. There are a lot of people out there who claim to be able to rejuvenate batteries, and I did some Googling and came across EDTA. EDTA stands for ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, commonly used as a food additive, and once dissolved in solution, seems to work well releasing hardened deposits from the plates. Anyhow, it worked for me, and the EDTA continues to protect. One of the things I check regularly is the specific gravity of the battery acid. On the side of these batteries is a table describing preferred specific gravity values, values I never seem to be able to reach. So instead, I take a relative measure as an indication of the charge level. A higher reading is good, and lower, not so good. In any event, I try not to obsess about the actual number. In the winter, maintaining a good charge used to prove difficult, and come December, January, I'd have to fire up the generator and use this old heavy-duty charger to top up the batteries. Adding a couple of extra panels cured this problem, and I have not had to employ the charger since. Upstairs, in the house, we use a 750-watt inverter to provide 120 volts as needed, and the 12-volt lighting is wired and switched for convenience. It's a good feeling to return on a dark night and turn on the bright, warm halogen lights running on battery power, knowing that the sun will shine again tomorrow. So there it is, a rather ad hoc system, far from perfect, which I have managed to adapt over the years, providing reliable power from the sun at a reasonable price. Coming soon, I'll be installing a new system over in the workshop, and I hope to be able to show you more of the nuts and bolts of a solar power installation. Thanks as always for watching and commenting. If you're not yet a subscriber, please click on the upcoming subscribe button and take a look around the rest of my channel. Once subscribed, YouTube will email you each time I post a new video. So until then, thanks again. See you next time.